trying to stir up.
The devil went down to Georgia. Okay. He was looking for a soul.
Okay,
Sid,
you don't today. Have to manhandle me.
But you know, you can try and fix the relationship all you like with the labor movement. But you know, in the words of that great poet that talked about dance me to the end of love, the liberals have actually lost the love of the labor movement and of those friends that they had. And there's no amount of courtship that's going to bring that back, because you cannot go after the bedrock, the middle class, the working class, those who are in poverty. You cannot attack them in a cross election in Kitchener-Waterloo and expect that somehow we're just magically going to forget about it, Dalton, or your successor. It doesn't work that way. When you lose their respect, when you attack people, when you go after folks who are participating in a community startup program, when you go after women who are living in abusive relationships, and you cut the program out from underneath their legs as they try to get themselves in a better situation in life. When you go after the homeless folks who try to use that program to get themselves in off the street, in out of the cold. What happens when you cut that program? You're taking hope away from the homeless in this city. And that, my friend, we understand, because we stand in solidarity with the homeless. We stand in solidarity with people who are living in poverty. And for God's sake, the province has got to be more about how we share the wealth in this province, and less about appealing to the corporate sector. Less about corporate tax cuts. So my friends, I know the Liberals are listening right now. And the issue, yes, it's about collective bargaining rights. And yes, it's about respect for education workers. But it's also about the austerity program. And it's about killing that austerity program. Because all across Europe and in the United Kingdom, they're going into double-dip recessions. And just last week, we heard that the job creation in this province is flat on its back. And yet the corporations and the banks in particular, made $7.8 billion in profits in the last year alone. The McGuinty government said themselves we're going to write off $1.4 billion in corporate taxes that they decided not to collect because the corporate welfare bums won't pay their fair share. And instead they go to education workers and the broader public sector and take away their basic democratic rights to negotiate a collective agreement with the local employers. That's what happens when the government loses sight of who it is that they're representing and about the social programs that we've got in this province. Like the bedrock, the two twin bedrock social programs has got to be education and healthcare. And yet they're the two programs that are being assaulted by this austerity program. So my friends, it is way bigger and way more broader than Bill 115. And I'm glad that the teachers today, in solidarity with the rest of the labor movement, recognize that fact, that we're all in this fight together. Each and every one of us. What this demonstration is saying. Listen to that crowd. Listen to that crowd, my friend. Listen. Listen to the voice of democracy. This is what democracy sounds like. This is what democracy sounds like. This is what democracy sounds like. This is what democracy looks 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 like. So my friends, today we've turned the corner. Today, we said, standing in solidarity with 90 community organizations, We are saying loud and clear to the Liberals, you can elect whoever you like, because you're electing the leader of the third party, no matter what you do. No matter what you do. And we now have an opportunity.